Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 15.4 Beta 2. This is currently available to developers, and hopefully by the time you're watching this video, it will be out to public beta testers as well. This came in at 887.8 megabytes, that's on my iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it was similarly sized on all the devices here, from the iPhone 8 Plus, iPhone 10, iPhone 11, and along with this, Apple also released iPadOS 15.4 Beta 2, WatchOS 8.5 Beta 2, tvOS 15.4 Beta 2, and macOS 12.3 Beta 2. Those are all currently available. Now, if you're installing the betas, one thing to note from the Apple notes is that if you're on an iPad Pro 12.9-inch 5th generation, like this one here, or 3rd generation 11-inch iPad Pro, you can only update to iPadOS 15.4 Beta 2 from iPadOS 15.4 Beta 1. You have to go from Beta 1 to Beta 2. You cannot go from 15.3 to Beta 2. There's some odd bug with it that they mentioned specifically in this update. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So first we'll go to Settings, then General, then About, and as you can see, the build number is 19E5219E, and this particular update does have some new features in it, some we can see, some we can't, but the first new feature is a modem update. So they did update the modem, whether that be on an iPhone 13 Pro Max or an iPhone 12, they updated it to 1.57.00 on this device. It may be a little bit different on your device as well. That should help with connectivity, although connectivity on Beta 1 has been okay. It should help with switching between different cellular networks or switching between different available speeds and things like that. So that has been updated. The first thing I wanted to mention is that on every device I booted up here, it came up to the hello screen. So you can see on the 8 Plus, that's why I had the screen off. It came up to the hello screen on every single device here when I booted it up, and then made me go through a few different setup options. So now you can see that I'm in and it's working like you would expect. So for some reason, it seems like it fully installed or kind of reset some of those settings upon the initial install. Now, as far as features and updates, well, the first thing is in the Magnifier app. So within the Magnifier app, one thing I mentioned in the iOS 15.4 Beta 1 additional feature videos that I've done is that there's a new camera icon here. Well, now if you tap on the camera icon, it looks a little bit different. So it says auto, close up, and front. Before, it looked different than that. So I have the example here on the iPhone 10, which actually has Beta 1 on it, and you can see what it looked like. So we had a little slider before. I kind of like the slider better. Now we've got this sort of menu here that looks a little bit different. So that's the first change. Within Beta 2, Apple has added a new feature that they announced today would be coming later this year. And you'll see on the news release, it says, or Apple's newsroom, it says Apple empowers businesses to accept contactless payments through Tap to Pay on iPhone. So you'll be able to tap to pay and even use your credit cards with Tap to Pay capability on certain iPhones that support it. That code can be found within Beta 2. And Steve Mosier, again, who I've referenced many times, my friend here, posted a picture of what that looks like within the code. So you have this new sort of graphic that shows up and a new sound once that payment has been made. Very similar to what you see on maybe a cashier or a register where you're tapping your credit card. So that's something they've updated directly in here. There's also code that's been found in here as well, again by Steve, that references allowing you to install third-party apps outside of the App Store. Now, they may need to get this ready due to lawsuits and things that are pending against them and different bills that have gone through the Senate talking about antitrust and allowing third-party apps. So some of that code is here. It's not fully functional, as far as I'm aware, that I've been able to get it to work, but the code is actually there, somewhat ready to go. So we could see maybe third-party app stores or third-party apps installed, just like you can do on macOS, but on iPhone. Also within the code is updates to Apple's Digital ID. We've heard about this since the initial introduction of iOS 15, but we've yet to see it roll out to the public. It's said to be rolling out in maybe a few states and tried out in a couple airports where we could use our ID on our phone to check through different TSA checkpoints or airports within the United States using our iPhone or Apple Watch. Of course, you can use your physical ID instead, but it looks like if your state supports it, we might have that rolling out soon, but it's not active yet, but they are getting ready. If you're using Face ID with a mask and maybe it can't see you because your phone's laying down on a table or the camera is below your eyes, I got a new prompt that says look down to unlock. So when you're wearing a mask, this will show up if it needs to maybe scan your face a little bit differently to unlock your phone. phone. So that's something they've updated in beta 2. Now, one thing I checked, since many of you asked, is Face ID on older devices is not yet supported on any of the devices other than iPhone 12 or newer. So I did check on the iPhone 11. If we go to Face ID and passcode, you'll see on the left on the iPhone 11, we don't have the option like we do on the 13 Pro Max with use Face ID with a mask and then the ability to add glasses. So it looks like it reset the add glasses part with installing this update. So you may want to set that up again, but it deleted that, but it's not on older devices yet. Maybe we'll see that in the future, but it's not there now. Now in accessibility, there's an update as well, although you can't really see it, but if you use VoiceOver, this can be very helpful for those that need it. So if you turn on VoiceOver, this is a way to explain what's on the screen. We'll turn it on for now, and you have to learn how to use it, but I'll show you what this is. If we go into the camera, within the camera, if we're in cinematic mode on one of the new iPhone 13 models, it will better explain what things are and help you know where to tap to focus, how to tap to focus, and what you're locked on. So if I tap, so it's saying focus locked, and it's giving us more information about it. So that's been updated. Let me turn that back off. There we go. And now it's off. But there's some new VoiceOver options within there, more than just for that specific thing, but cinematic mode is one of the biggest changes there. One thing I wanted to mention is a new change in the update from 15.3 to beta 1 that I didn't mention in the more new features videos that I did earlier this week. So if we go into shortcuts, and maybe we create a shortcut and add a battery, they've changed these icons for those battery modes. So if I bring in 15.3 here, you'll see get battery level looks a little bit different. They've sort of changed the battery icon, and then also set low power mode has changed to sort of an orangish icon. So they've updated that with this particular set of betas. So just small changes, but something they've changed. Also, with the introduction of 15.4, we got new SharePlay options within music and a new icon within certain applications. However, there were some issues with that icon. So if we go into Apple Fitness, go to Fitness Plus, maybe select a workout, tap the three dots, you can see the SharePlay icon. Prior to beta 2, this was actually not aligned properly in a lot of apps. It's now aligned where it should be. And again, thanks to Braden for pointing this out, as he mentioned that. I didn't notice that initially. Within this update, they've resolved two issues that they've mentioned specifically in the notes. The first one has to do with iCloud Plus custom email domains. I mentioned that in beta 1, where they added the option for iCloud Mail. If you have iCloud Plus, you can add a custom domain. However, email address verification was not completing properly before. That's been resolved in this issue, so that should work for you. Also, if you're in the EU, there was a delay of verification when adding a digital health certificate within the health app. That should be resolved and it should work properly now. Now, there's also 15 known issues, and there's a few notable issues that still exist in beta 2. So signing into iPad is limited to apps in this beta. So when you're signing in, there could be issues there. The health app can crash when you attempt to onboard the blood oxygen feature from within the app. Also, pairing of thread accessories. So if you're using a thread accessory with your home app, that won't work at all. Also, purchasing downloaded content again from the iTunes store and TV app may cause it to sort of fail on the device. And in order to fix that, you'll need to reboot it. So there's quite a few notable issues as well as some others. So as far as that goes, it seems to be stable so far, but there's definitely some issues within this. However, there's no mention of fixing the storage bug, and it seems like it's still there. I've seen people mention this already. It did take a while to load. It does seem like it's loading okay for me now, although system data hasn't, but it's just kind of odd and they haven't addressed this specifically. It doesn't affect functionality, but it's something that's more of an annoyance. Also, the pink screen bug they haven't mentioned at all, where your device can completely go to a pink or purple display and then reboot. That hasn't been fixed, or at least they haven't mentioned that it has. And I know people were experiencing that with beta 1, so it could still be here with beta 2. Also, the music streaming bug, where it could use additional processing power and cause poor battery life. Again, that has not been addressed, or at least they haven't mentioned it, but we'll have to see after a few days using this beta. Now, as far as if you want to try this update and if you should install iOS 15.4 beta 2, I would say probably hold off at this point. If you have a critical app that you need to use, or you have some issues that may affect your overall productivity on the device. But if you have an extra device or you're already on beta 1, I would definitely install it. With these betas, there's going to be some additional bugs since there's so many new features in them or changes. So maybe give it a few days before you try it out, and I'll be doing a follow-up to let you know about stability and things like that. As far as overall performance, performance does seem to be okay. I did run benchmarks on these. We'll take a look at a moment, but performance is okay. Opening different apps, whether that be music or something else. I'm opening it for the first time on the 8 Plus here. So it's just loading off the network. It's taking a moment and it seems to be okay. Let's scroll here. It seems to be nice and smooth, and opening different apps should be fine as well. So this is a newer device. Normally I use a 6S Plus to check out Minecraft. So let's see how quickly it loads here. Typically it's pretty fast, but generally they'll have good frame rates. We'll use recommended settings, hit play. And I installed the beta for the first time on this device, so that's why some things are reset. We'll give it just a moment and see how long this takes. So it's going along pretty quickly, and it's a fairly new phone, so we'll give it a moment to build this and see what the frame rates are like. It took about 5 to 10 seconds to load that, probably about 5 or so, and frame rates look pretty smooth, so no issues here on this device. Of course, I wouldn't expect it to be any different really on a 6S Plus or anything else if it was performing fine for you before. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the benchmarks, and then we'll talk about when to expect iOS 15.4 Beta 3 and the release candidate. So we'll go into Geekbench 5, and right after installing the update, I ran this, and I had 1,726 for single core, 4,716 for multi-core. If we take a look at the history, you'll see that on January 27th with Beta 1, we had a little bit higher single core score by 3, and multi-core score is actually better today by 7. So it's actually within the range, they should perform about exactly the same. So benchmarks are pretty good. Let's take a look at all of these devices. From left to right, we have the iPad Pro 12.9 from 2021, followed by the iPhone 8 Plus, then the iPhone 11, then the iPhone 13 Pro Max. And all of these are really close to what we had with Beta 1. And so yours should be performing similarly to this, and you really shouldn't see any differences there. So we had great performance with Beta 1. I would expect great performance with Beta 2 as well. When it comes to battery life will take a few days to know for sure, so I'll be covering that more in depth in my follow-up, but we can take a look at Beta 1. It was not great for me, and not for quite a few other people. So under battery health, you'll see I have 100%, and if we go to the last 10 days, yesterday I had 2 hours and 32 minutes of screen on time, 8 hours and 14 minutes of screen off time, and 11% was used by Siri, and I didn't even use Siri. So there's definitely some odd bugs in Beta 1. Hopefully we'll see much better battery life with Beta 2, as that used over 50% of my battery. So I would expect similar updates there. As far as battery life on the iPad, I had some weird bugs with the iPad battery life if you saw my follow-up video. So under settings, I don't know why it wants Face ID, but we'll go to settings, battery. Give it just a moment. And over the last 10 days, you'll see it gives battery life. And I was getting about 5 hours of screen on time. The odd thing is it says last charge to 100% 2 hours ago. Prior to this, it was actually saying a couple days back, even though I had charged it. So hopefully they've updated this and fixed those bugs. But they haven't mentioned it, but it does seem to actually be registering correctly, at least on the iPad. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 15.4 Beta 3 or the release candidate, typically, I think we're going to be at a 1 to 2 week cycle. I'm thinking we're at a 1 week cycle for the reason of a March event on March 8th. We're expecting an Apple event on March 8th, and that would give us a few more betas or a couple more betas and a release candidate before that release. So I'm thinking probably by the 15th, we'll have Beta 3, then Beta 4 on the 22nd or sometime around there, and then maybe a release candidate in the first week of March with a final release in the second week of March, maybe after that event. It's just based off of what we see year over year, and we'll have to wait and see. If we don't have a beta next week, we're still on that bi-weekly schedule, and we'll have to wait maybe till later in March. We're just not sure yet, but we'll have to see if we have that early next week. We also could have iOS 15.3.1 to fix a couple bugs, since we had watchOS 8.4.1 with a small bug fix and security update. So we could see that even this week as well, but we'll have to wait and see. But again, we should have that March event in the second week of March, it's looking like. And so that's it for everything in this particular beta. Of course, if I find any additional features, as it does take some time to sort of see those features pop up, I'll let you know in a separate video later this week. Also, if you've found any additional features I haven't mentioned in the video, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.